and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. So here we have given a front view and a top view, and we have to draw its isometric view. So from this two-dimensional views, you have to draw a three-dimensional view. So this is a point O, which will be the starting point. The width of the total front view is 30 plus 15 plus 15. Now the diameter of the semicircle is not given, so we'll consider it as 60 millimeter. So the diameter of the semicircle is 60, so the radius will be 30, half of the diameter. So this distance will be 30. So the total distance of the front view will be 30 plus 30 plus 30. That will be 90. Height is 70. And the width will nothing but the diameter of the semicircle, that is 60. So now as we have got the three dimension, so now we can begin with the actual sum. So first, we'll draw a straight line. Mark a point O on it. So this is point O. From this point, we will draw two angles, 30 degree on this side, 90 degree and 30 degree on the other side. We'll draw the lines through it. So these are our base axis, 30 degree, 30 degree, 90 degree. This you have to do in each and every sum. Now for drawing the front view, this side will be the front view as the O is given. So according to the O point, right side will be the front view and left side will be the side view. So we have marked the dimensions 90, height 70 and width as 60. Now from those points, we'll construct a box. Rectangular box, you have to just draw parallel lines through the points and we will construct a rectangular box through it. So this box makes sure that our whole isometric view comes inside that box only. So it is easy to draw then. Just while drawing the box, keep in mind, check the dimensions. If the dimensions are wrong, then you have not drawn the parallel lines properly. So see how I have drawn the box. So this part is done. Now our whole three-dimensional figure will be inside this box only. Just check whether the dimensions are properly mapped. Not, you can change it at this point only. So everything seems perfect. Now moving forward, now starting with the front view, this is the point O. So right side we have the front view. First we will draw this semicircle. This semicircle from the three-dimensional view, it look like an ellipse. So, as you know the rule, for drawing the semicircle, we have to construct a square with its diameter. Now, first, the height of the semicircle is 20, which is given. So, we have marked a point about 20. From there, we will draw a square with sides as the diameter of the semicircle, that is 60. So, here we have marked a point 60. This is already 60. So we'll construct a square. As the height of the semicircle given is 20. Draw draw the square lightly, as the semicircle should be dark and there will be many projection lines, so you'll get confused, so draw it light. So with sides as 60, we have constructed the square. So this square is done at a height of 20 above. Now next procedure for drawing the semicircle or circle, first we have to join the longest diagonal. So this is the longest diagonal. Then from the smaller diagonals, we have to take two lines and join at the opposite midpoint. So this is the midpoint. From the opposite point, join. Then this midpoint, opposite diagonal, join. And same from this side also. This is the midpoint. From the opposite diagonal, join. Through this line, midpoint, join. Now we have got 4 points here to plot the semicircle, but for semicircle we require only 2 points. For circle we require 4 points. A semicircle will be on this side. So on compass, taking radius as this, draw the curve. Then keeping your pointer here, radius as this much, continue with the curve and join till this point. So this semicircle has been created. So the semicircle is created. Now the same semicircle, you have to plot it below also. The height is 20. So from the same 2 points, you have to project it downwards to a height of 20. So this point will mark the point 20 below. Now with the same distance as we have drawn this curve, you have to draw it below 20, as the height of this semicircle is 20. So now the curve below is also plotted. So the curve will end till this point, and from this point we'll draw the straight line. So this line is this from the front view. Now here also the semicircle will come, the curve part. So we have to plot this point also below 20. So from here we have to plot or mark the point 20 or shift it downward to 20 as we did it earlier. So taking the radius of curve this much, and we have to plot this below. So we'll move it below 20 and we'll draw the curve. Not need to draw the whole curve. You have to draw the curve till the tangent touches. So the tangent to the curve, join it dark, and this part is done. So we have drawn the semicircle. Just make it smooth if some part is missing. So we have drawn the semicircle, the thickness of 20. Now the diameter of this inner circle is not given. You can assume it. You can assume it 20 diameter, or you can assume it 30 diameter as you want. If it's given in the question, according to that, use that. Here it is not given anything, so I'm considering it diameter of. Now for drawing this circle, again we have to draw a square with side of 20. So from the center, 10 on both the sides. We have marked. From those points, we'll draw parallel lines. Draw it again lightly. Now from these two lines, from their center, so this thickness is 60, from the center 30, mark on both the sides 10 10, and from those points again draw parallel lines which will construct a square at the center, because the circle is at the center. Now again same procedure, join the longest diagonal from the shorter ends, draw two lines touching the midpoint at the opposite. So center point, from the opposite point join, from the opposing point join at the center point. Same with the other side also. For semicircle we require 2 points, for circle we require all the 4 points. Now from these 4 points we will draw the curve. So placing the pointer here with radius as this line, we'll draw the curve with same radius, keeping the pointer here. Draw the curve on the other side as well. Now changing the radius, keep on this point with this as radius, draw the curve, and on the opposite end draw the curve. Now this circle has been plotted. Now next, moving forward, as you can see, this distance is 30, and from there it has been extended up. So first we'll increase this line, this is also 30. Now this is the dark line, this is the slant line. So from the end, first we'll increase at a height of 70. So this line is this. Now on the top side you can see you have grooves. So first we'll mark the points from the center. 10 10 on each sides will give you 20. So this distance is 20. There we'll mark the dark line as the center part is cut, as you can see from the top view. Now we have to draw this slant line. The slant height is 16, so from here I have marked a point 16 below. We'll draw a parallel line through it. Now the width of the slant line is still 30, so from this parallel line we'll mark a line, mark a point at 30, and we'll draw a slant line. So drawing a dark line from this point, so this is this slant line. Now on this slant line we have a cut at a distance of 15. First we'll complete this slant line and we'll draw it, the cut part, later. So we'll draw it lightly. This is the total slant line. So the slant part is done. Now on that slant line we have a cut at a distance of 15. So the 15 distance is not like this, it is horizontally 15. This distance is 15, so we'll mark a point 15 here. This is the point 15. So the slant line or the cut part extension is still 15. Now we'll extend this line to the slant line. So taking this line as a reference, draw a line parallel, and through this slant line, drawing this line parallel to the slant line. Now on this slant line, through the center point, we'll mark a distance of 40. So from the center, 20 on each side. So this total distance will be 40, and then join this. So this is the cut part we have drawn, which is on this slant line. Now this part is done. Now just the remaining part. Join this line dark. Join this line dark. And with this line, we'll complete our three-dimensional figure. So we are almost done. This is the final touch-up. This part, you have to draw dark as this is the cut part. So this part is done. And our whole three-dimensional figure is done. Just marking of the dimensions and the front view. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to my channel. See you in the next lecture. If you have any doubts, do let me know in the comment section.